That's it. I only ate turkey. I just eat turkey every day with gravy. That's the problem, is people want to know what the secret is. The secret is you can't do it in a month. It takes 8 months and or a year or a lifetime of consistency, working out every single day and eating properly and truly feeding yourself, not starving yourself, but giving yourself proper nutrition to heal. You have to burn off all the crap you've put in your body, and then you have to replace it with really good food and fuel.
Oh, I'm going to die. I'm so tired. Everything hurts. Running is impossible.
Transforming yourself is really not hard. It requires consistency and dedication, and you have to be willing to sacrifice the things that you want. You have to trade things that are fun, like alcohol consumption, meals at restaurants, things like that, for, you know, long, arduous periods of time exercising and physically exhausting and grueling work. I was capable of doing it. I think anybody could do it if they wanted to. And time is going to go by just as fast whether you're doing it or not. So who do you want to be 8 months from now? You want to be in good shape, then get on it today.
Having fitness does enhance your life. It makes you feel better. I think it's like very effective in terms of mentally making you tougher and stronger and feeling better about yourself. The most fun I've ever had doing something active, I probably can't mention on this. My son was the result of it.
You only live in that impeccable shape for maybe 24 hours. You know, seriously, it's like several months built up to like it's like an orchid that blooms and dies on the same day, you know? It's like care and concern, watering and the perfect amount of sunshine for 6 months, and then it just and you take a selfie.
The trainer was like, if you're going to do beer and EpiCard, limit it to 12 beers and make sure you do it after midnight.
Well, was it hard to actually get the muscle bulk on?
It was. The eating was probably the most difficult part. Yep. It wasn't the fun kind of eating either. It was copious amounts of chicken breast and various animal proteins and what have you.
Is that real?
Yeah, I wouldn't have spent 6 months in the gym. I read the comic books and noticed the character was 700 kilograms, so that's certainly a little bit of fire.
Were you doing push-ups before you went on air to record?
Yeah, there was all sorts of, little dumbbell things, and everyone's standing around looking at you.
Getting the muscle pump.
Idiot. The workout was probably more difficult than actual filming. It was, my body doesn't sit naturally at that weight, so it was consuming many, many calories and protein, being the main one, and working out 6-7 days a week.
That's you?
Not in this film,
though. Get it together.
Don't spend enough time doing this.
So you got to get your shirt off of this. Do you mind doing this? You just don't mind? He said, I've spent 6 months getting into shape for this. No, I don't mind.
He's built like a brick shit house.
Chris, you're fake.
Thank you, babe.
Look at you. So muscly and everything.
We'll be right back.
he showed up at about 162. And we needed to get him to about 185, 190.
It appears to be 179 pounds, sir.
2 hours lifting every day.
Protein every few hours.
We were carb depleting as well, so we were eating chicken and broccoli all day, nothing else. Not that sweets. It was rubbish, man. It was horrible. It's unnecessary. And I don't know why anybody does it for a living.
Getting into a gym is something that I'm not comfortable with at all, to be honest. So I was very concerned. My whole thing, it was quite alarming. The amount of exercise that was demanded, you know, and athleticism and discipline and structure wasn't up my alley at all.
Punches would go through all the time, you know, like, you know, an elbow or a knee. You know, Joel tore his meniscus, took a few weeks off. I tore the ligament of my right hand, tore, you know, I broke my foot and cracked my ribs, you know. Like, and we were still fighting. And it was, you know, it's like, I'm an actor. This is too much.
So for about 3 months, we trained in Boston, and it was a couple hours a day, and it was brutal. The tricky part was eating.
You have to eat lots?
Just eating everything all the time.
That sounds awful.
See, you think it sounds nice, but it's not just like cheeseburgers. I mean, you have to eat like these just bland, naked pieces of chicken and rice, and it's not that appetizing.
Right.
And you're just so full. It's a pretty uncomfortable feeling. You want to look, you know.
Pump the guns.
I'm like big. So every time they yelled cut, I'd run off set, and they brought some weights on the set for me. So every time we had a break in filming, I would run off and just start lifting weights. But as a result, you know, you're working out pretty much the entire day for multiple days. So by the end of the sequence, I was exhausted.
Chris Evans' man boobs, really?
Yeah.
What are they like face to face?
Hurt. Very, very real. And I couldn't quite help myself during the scene. It was the first time I saw him, and it was the first time I was that close, so I just kind of touched them gently. You're right.
I can't really blame you, I guess.
Yeah, they're really impressive, yeah.
Son of a bitch did it.
There's boxes in my storage, fat suits, skinny suits, normal suits. And and right now, in this shape, I don't have any suits.
My journey is that I began working at a gym behind the counter as the skinny guy, making fun of all the guys working out, because I could see no point in what they were doing. So I was by no means that, and I think people kind of know that I was just a tall, skinny guy who had to kind of get into shape.
The Wolverine diet is strict. It's about 4,000 calories a day, maybe 4,500 as I'm bulking up, and then it drops down as I'm leaning up. It drops down to about 3,500 calories. Not the fun calories. This is the chicken, fish, maybe steak. Always protein, 6 times a day. Protein, steamed vegetables, and occasionally some brown rice or something like that. Protein shakes. And just like that, no alcohol, no sugar, pretty much nothing that's fun.
Hero and I have this fight, and I have my shirt off in that scene, so it's a key sort of moment physically. I had to be in peak condition for that. And I went on a water dehydration diet so that I could be as ripped and cut as possible for that. So for 24, 30 hours, you don't drink any liquids. So I had a massive headache. I trained really hard that morning, and
it's you start cramping up, and then we were doing this fight with I had the real claws on, he had the sword.
Is it safe to say this is the furthest you've pushed yourself physically?
Yeah.
Every time he has to do one of these, the work involved, which people don't see, is how hard he works on just getting the body right for it. I mean, it's such strict diet and workout, and every time I turn around, he's on a treadmill or he's lifting a weight. Or
basically train for 3 hours a day and eat
a lot of protein,
a lot of food. And I actually got the diet from Dwayne The Rock Johnson, who's a mate of mine. And every day what I do is I eat for 8 hours and I fast for 16. So from about 10 in the morning till 6, for this I eat way too much and then nothing after that.
We gotta get to the gym. And there ain't no stopping us. But then again, what would Hugh Jackman do?
It's 5:45. We're at the gym. Focus! Come on. Come on. Come on.
Trainer before we started the film wanted to pack on about 10 pounds on and muscle up. You know, you gotta be able to lift people over your head and throw them around and fight blood-sucking vampires. It's a tough thing when you work 14, 15 hour day and then you have to get up at 4:30 or 5 in the morning and go lift weights for 2 hours and then go to work all day.
I cleared my schedule for almost 8 or 9 months and just worked primarily on getting ready for the role.
6 days a week he was in the gym, always up at 4 in the morning doing his weights. He had a trainer. He stuck to it religiously, and it always made me laugh because on Saturdays he was allowed to go and drink and eat as much as he wanted. He had the one day off during the week where he could do that.
He was up at like 3 in the morning working out and eating cardboard, and it was pretty pretty cardboard? Amazing.
Not a great diet, no.
Cardboard didn't sound like it tasted too good.
No, drywall is also awful.
Yeah.
But high in protein, so
and no calories.
There we go. Yeah, exactly.
I'll just enjoy this glass of water. I'm stuffed.
How can you feel like $1 million when you're in shape, when you're always exhausted? Like, when you're always working out, you never feel what it's like to be, you know, fully strong. I just always feel like, whoa, God, my chest feels like somebody, like, drove a truck over it.
When you gain, like, 7 or 8, 9 pounds of muscle, you look gigantic.
Right. So there's no way you're gaining 40 pounds of muscle. You'd be
not
a third.
Yeah, not without, like, just pure dragon blood being pumped into your veins every day.
There's no CGI or anything on your six-pack or anything like that?
I wish. Someone's got to invent that.
Do you stay in shape then for anything?
No. I think,
or is it per...
Yeah, if it's for the job. Like, I just wrapped Deadpool, so I still got it. No, I worked out like crazy for that. But you know, once the... Literally, like, 5 days... When there's 5 days left of shooting, I just stop everything.
We'll be right back.
100%. The training has been a journey of discovery, just like Superman's journey of discovery. Superman learned he could fly. I learned I could do all sorts of things in the gym, which I never thought possible.
He started out, I think his deadlift was about 245 pounds. After a period of time, he pulled 435. And it all came from hard work and discipline and paying attention to his diet and to his sleep and to his recovery. And ultimately, I think Henry Cavill is Superman. It's not easy for anyone, but that doesn't mean that it was painful. Obviously, there are times where he was cursing me under his breath, sometimes to my face, but it's expected. Having it be difficult, I think, makes the end result worthwhile.
He's opened my eyes to seeing past what I thought were my limits and the ability to crush me in the gym, but just enough that I can't walk out properly and I feel horrible and feel a little sick, but I still want to come back.
Henry's work to get his body in shape also just evolved into getting his mind and spirit into shape.
It's not the kind of training which just makes you look pretty. It's the kind of training which, first and foremost, is useful. Your perceived boundaries are not your actual boundaries. You can push way beyond those, and I wouldn't necessarily recommend doing it all the time, but as long as you have someone who's very knowledgeable guiding you, then you can do it.
What Henry did was just a ridiculous amount of hard work, like literally a ridiculous amount. And it was 5 months of just, you know, getting up at the crack of dawn, training like a maniac, and, you know, really, I think, using those moments of extreme pain and agony to sort of say, like, this is what Superman probably felt like when he was a child trying to assimilate to Earth's atmosphere.
I work out twice a day, 6 days a week when I'm training for a shoot like today or for True Blood or Magic Mike or any other project that I have. So it's a lot. If you want to put on empty weight, eat empty food. I always say I eat to build. So, you know, I work out really hard in the gym and I eat a lot of protein in order to provide me with the building blocks to maximize that training. So there's no sugar, no carbs, no alcohol. So you have to cut out a lot of that fun, delicious stuff that most people really like.
I've spent the past 25 years, the past two-thirds of my life, searching out the best trainers on the planet, the best methods on the planet. I did this completely naturally, no steroids, no human growth hormones. I was not born genetically to put on muscle. I was cursed with long limbs. But somehow I found a way to do it.
I got into powerlifting and got into the traditional Olympic lifts. My diet is very strict, but not strict in a way that it's not fun. I'm a carnivore. So I get to eat as much meat as I can pretty much put down. I'm not somebody that's against fat. I'm against sugar. I think sugar when you're training is the number one killer. You gotta get rid of the sugar, get rid of the bread.
I didn't have it easy and I eliminated all of the excuses and just know that if I can do it, you can do it. Anything is possible.
Yeah. I was writing, and one of the reasons why I thought, well, this movie couldn't really be made is because of the Trevor's character, the whole weight loss issue. And never in my wildest dreams did I think an actor would actually go to the lengths that Christian has gone to.
It feels great. It feels like a kind of a victory because I did kind of just emaciate and destroy myself. And, you know, to the point where I kind of just watching me run is a joke because I just have no leg muscles or anything.
Watching this man walk around 120 pounds, not eating for weeks, I just didn't think it was possible.
I didn't eat. That was it.
When I first met Christian, he was extraordinarily thin, having lost an enormous amount of weight for The Machinist, which he was about to go off and shoot.
He did call me and say, well, you know, how do you look right now? You know, like, how am I going to seriously be able to suggest to Warner Brothers that you could play Batman ever if, you know, you're that skinny?
Hey, perfect fit.
He then proceeded to put on a lot of weight in muscle terms and really try and bulk up because I had impressed upon him the idea that for Bruce Wayne to really fill that suit, he was going to have to be very, very large.
I was just stuffing my face all day long and lifting heavy weights and eating more and eventually went up to like 220 pounds. I just listened to what he said about get as big as you possibly can, so that's what I did. You know, but I was kind of like a bear. I wasn't really like a martial arts, you know, guy all lean and ripped and everything like that. I could see the look on Chris's face, you know. He looked at me and it was like, oh, Christ, you know, what has this guy done? It was a moment of panic where I realized, oh, crap, you know. I took Chris at his exact word about get as big as you can, but he didn't really think I was going to get that big. A number of the crew I'd worked with on previous movies, they looked at me and they were like, bloody hell, Chris, what are we doing here, Fat Man or Batman? And so I realized, okay, that's not what he had meant. So I had to then try and lose a lot of weight.
We worked on his stamina and built his muscle tone so we could bring his body back up to being what it needed to be for Batman.
Christian showed extraordinary levels of self-discipline and dedication to the role to be able to do that. A lot of actors, when you start working with them, they'll say they're going to lose a bit of weight for the part or whatever, and the wardrobe people will kind of roll their eyes and go, yeah, sure, because they very often don't.
Got to just say to yourself, do I think it's good? Do I think I've done a good job on this? And that's it. And that I get my satisfaction from working on it right here, right now.